This is the V60 pour over dripper. And in this video, I'm gonna share with you my personal favorite V60 recipe, one that I've been using daily for about 6 months now, and one that I absolutely enjoy using. I think it's easy, and I think you can make it at home too. Now, I won't say that this is the best recipe. Rather, I believe there's a lot of recipes that can be used in our arsenal for brewing great coffee at home. So today I'm gonna teach you about my method that I call the double double, a recipe that I think is easy, repeatable. I'm gonna teach you how to do it, why I do it, and at the end, we're gonna brew some coffee together and I'm gonna share my taste thoughts with you too. Now, like I've already mentioned, I'm calling this recipe the double double. Now, if you're Canadian, you know that means something very different in these parts.
Two creams and two sugars.
And that's because there's a really popular commodity cafe here in Canada that a lot of people do enjoy, and the double double is pretty popular there. But today we're not gonna be using those two creams and two sugars. It doesn't require any of those ingredients. Rather, double double is referring to the method in how we brew our coffee. So let's get right into this without further delay, how we brew the double double at home. The first thing that we're gonna need is 20 grams of coffee. Now we're gonna grind this about medium fine. If you're using the Niche Zero, I would say 33 to about 45, depending on the seasoning on your burrs. If it's brand new, you might need to go coarser. On the Comandante C40, we're looking about 22 to 24 clicks. On any other grinder, it will look similar to what's seen on the screen here compared to the Cruve Brewer. Regardless of what grinder that you're using, we're gonna use 20 grams of coffee. Now, this is gonna be a 1:16 brew ratio. So if you need to brew more coffee, just adjust accordingly. But in this video, we're gonna use 20 grams. Once we got our 20 grams ground medium fine, we're going to then rinse our filter of our V60. This is a very crucial step, but don't worry, at the end of this video, we're gonna do this together. Once you rinse that V60 filter, make sure to dump that water in the decanter, add your coffee, and this is where the first double of double double comes in. We're going to then double our dry weight in water for the bloom. If you've got 20 grams of coffee, that means 40 grams of water going to be added to the bloom phase. In the bloom phase, we're waiting about 45 seconds. It's a little bit longer than traditionally, but I want to make sure everything is well saturated. Speaking of which, once you pour that water, hit that timer and give a small swirl to make sure that all the grounds are saturated and that extraction starts as soon as possible. Once you've done your first pour, we're then moving on to the second pour of three total pours. The second pour, we're going to pour to about 60 to 65% of our total water weight. In the case of our recipe, we're using 20 grams of coffee at a 1:16 ratio. So we're gonna pour to about 200 grams of water. We're going for a total of 320 grams, by the way. So 200 grams of water in that second pour. So to recap, a bloom, 40 grams for 45 seconds. Once you've hit 45 seconds, we're gonna then pour to 200 grams in small swirls, making sure that all the coffee is well saturated. We're gonna pour at a medium speed, not too slow, but not too aggressively. We wanna pour to that 200 grams within 30 to 45 seconds, so at about 115 to 130. And once you've poured that water, don't swirl it, let it sit for about 20 seconds. And after 20 seconds, it's going to draw down, but not completely. You're gonna then pour your third pour, which is the second double of double double. The first being double your dry weight for the bloom, the second being the following number of pours after the bloom. And with this third pour, I want you to pour slightly more aggressively. That's gonna stir up all the grounds in that bed, agitate it a little bit more. But what I find is that third pour allows us to control our brew a little bit more, which I'll explain later in this video. That third pour, you should be able to do in 15 to 25 seconds. I normally pour all three pours before I hit the 2 minute mark or just at 2 minutes. Now we're aiming for a total drawdown time between 3 minutes to 3 minutes and 30 seconds. I tend to lean on the side of higher extracted coffees, so I lean towards 3 minutes and 30 seconds, but I've had great coffees above and great below. This is simply a guide. That's the double double. Double your dry weight for the bloom, double pour after the bloom. So let's talk about why I use this method, the advantages I found with this method, and even my taste preferences I find in this method. But first, let's talk about the sponsor of today's video, which is Skillshare. Now, if you didn't know, Skillshare is an amazing community with thousands of classes for you to learn. Now, you might say, Kyle, what does this have to do with what we're talking about today? Skillshare has amazing classes that'll deepen your passions, explore existing skills, or just get lost in creativity with even in coffee. Right now, I'm enjoying an amazing class called Become Great with Coffee from Beginner to Barista from World of Latte Art. And there are so many classes on Skillshare just like this one to dive into some of your favorite passions, be it coffee, be it art, be it photography, whatever you're looking for, Skillshare is the platform to be on. I'm telling you guys, don't miss out on this. The first 1,000 people to click the link in the top of the description are gonna get 1 month of Skillshare for free. Literally, just the first 1,000 people. So pause the video, like right, hit the link. Hit the link. Then come back and watch the video. Go on, start learning, let's get creative, and thank you so much Skillshare for sponsoring this video. So while I'm brewing coffee, I'm gonna tell you why I really enjoy this method. Now, like I already mentioned, having multiple pours is some of my favorite ways to brew coffee because it helps me control the flow of my drawdown. As you know from my Tetsu Kasuya video, the 4-6 method, there are multiple pours to be able to not only control the flow of water, but also the sweetness and acidity. And that's very similar with this method too. I find that this creates a very sweet cup with balanced acidity. It's not as much acidity as we find in the 4-6 method using those coarser grind settings and 5-6 pours, but I find the sweetness on this cup and the extraction is a little bit higher, creating just a well-balanced and rounded cup. Something I love to do is having that second pour allows me to see the flow rate and drawdown time of that coffee. I can then adjust my third pour accordingly. If I feel like I grind maybe a little too fine or too coarsely, I can adjust that third pour to compensate for my mistake in that grind size. Now, this isn't something I do every morning. It is great though when dialing in a coffee to have some flexibility, being able to save that brand new coffee that you didn't want to waste and dump down the drain. Now on that final pour, make sure you do give it that swirl so you can get that nice flat bed. Bring down the coffee from the sidewalls of the dripper and make sure that there's as much extraction as possible. And this is just creates an absolutely wonderfully delicious cup. I love the sweetness that it creates. It's just a well-rounded cup. It has a full drinking experience from acidity to sweetness and everything in between. Like I already mentioned, this does translate to other drippers like the Chemex or the Kalita Wave. And this is looking like it's gonna draw down right on time at around that 3:30. Okay, 3:27. I won't be picky about that. You can see that final swirl at the end gives a nice flat bed. It brings all the coffee from the sidewalls down to the bed. A little journey pour there. So good. Let me know in the comments down below what you think. Are you gonna try the double double? Is this a method you think that is intriguing to you? Do you prefer the one pour method? Do you prefer multiple pour methods like the 4-6 method? Let me know in the comments down below your favorite V60 recipe. Maybe this one will be it. If you enjoyed this video, if it was all entertaining, or if I was able to make you smile, hit that like button. It really does help with the channel. We'll see you guys next time. Peace.